to be here now, to be able to participate with our friends in the temple open house and the forthcoming dedication is just like the greatest blessing that we could have ever hoped for.
With its towering skyscrapers, Tokyo, Japan, is the world's largest metropolis, home to more than 37 million people. The city is rich in history and tradition that goes back thousands of years, including its ancient temples and shrines. And where the first temple of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints was built in Asia. Now, after 42 years of service, the beloved Tokyo Japan Temple will open its doors to the public. Everyone, regardless of their religion or age, is invited to come and learn about the temple. From experiencing the tranquility and serenity of its improved gardens, to entering the sacred structure.
Japanese people are, they're temple-going people. It's just woven into their culture. It's part of their DNA. On a special day, they visit the temple or shrine. It has a striking similarity to what we, as Latter-day Saints, hold as one of our sacred rites and customs, as being able to go to the temple.
Much like temples of other faith, temples of the Church of Jesus Christ are dedicated sacred spaces where you can draw closer to God, understand the meaning of life, connect with your ancestors, and experience peace. Prior to its rededication, anyone who wishes may visit the temple.
Our friends who come through the temple are going to really be impressed and touched by the symbolic nature of what they see in the temple as we walk through together.
The Tokyo Japan Temple has deep spiritual significance to Latter-day Saints, like Makoto Fukuda, who joined the church when he was 16 years old. It will be more than 20 years before he would worship in a temple in his homeland.
日本中からたくさんの末日生徒が集まった日本地域総大会。
In 1975, thousands were assembled in the Nippon Budokan Arena when then church president Spencer W. Kimball made a historic announcement.
We therefore propose to you assembled here that we establish, build a temple in Tokyo, Japan for all of Asia.
私たち本当に興奮しました。そしてとてもですね、嬉しくてみんなで拍手をしたんです。
The temple, which serves tens of thousands of Latter-day Saints, closed its doors in September 2017 to undergo extensive renovations. Upgrades are made to the infrastructure.Water and electrical utility systems were modernized for energy efficiency. And a new annex building now sits next to the temple. The annex houses a chapel, a family history center, offices, and a new visitor center. From the moment you step foot on the temple grounds, a garden welcomes you with the sound of gentle flowing water.Natural stones surrounded by delicate vegetation give you a place to sit and ponder.
It's been a very special experience for all the neighbors that have been around to be able to see beautiful things that hasn't been here before, and they're really excited about that.
Meticulous care was taken to preserve the Ishidoro lanterns that have been on the property for decades. Now,The temple's landscaping appears to seamlessly flow into the popular Arisugawa Memorial Park nearby. As you enter the temple, Shibui, the feeling of quiet elegance invokes a sense of reverence.
This is the house of the Lord. This is where the presence of the Lord is. As you come in here, you could feel it.
Images of the Savior, Jesus Christ.And his ministry adorned the walls to remind us of his sacrifice and encourage introspection.
We consider the temple the house of the Lord, And so it is with respect that we build them, and with great respect that we dedicate them.
The exquisite materials used throughout the temple, the refined furnishings, and meticulous attention to detail enables temple patrons to focus on the purpose of the temple, to be edified and become closer to the Savior.
We keep them beautiful so that our hearts are aligned with the beauty that we see in the temple.
It feels warm, really, as you enter here. Artwork of cherry blossoms and pines, and it brings in some Japanese flavor to it.
The pine tree in Japanese culture symbolizes eternal life. Traditional art pieces depict nature, a contemplation of God's awe-inspiring power and goodness. Those who have been to the temple before will notice the biggest changes in the baptistry area.
Now we have a spacious chapel with in front of the baptismal font, very spacious. It gives a reverence and a nice feel to it.
Inside the baptistry is a water-filled font resting on the shoulders of 12 oxen that represent the 12 tribes of Israel. Latter-day Saints believe God wants all of His children to live with Him eternally. By entering the waters of baptism, as Jesus Christ taught by His own example. Inside the temple, baptisms are performed on behalf of our ancestors and loved ones.
We feel a closeness, a kinship with our ancestors when we enter temples and participate in the ordinances that take place there.
The bridal room is where women can dress in preparation for the eternal marriage ceremony, known as the sealing ordinance. The elegant decor of the bridal room was inspired by traditional kimono patterns as seen in the graceful carpet design. The paneling in the instruction room bears resemblance to shoji screens. The diffused lighting is reminiscent of rice paper used in shoji lanterns. Here, devout members learn about the purpose of life.
We learn about where did we come from? Why are we here? After this life, where will we go? We learn about the beauty of the earth that was provided by our Heavenly Father.
The sealing room is where families are united for eternity in marriage. The mirrors are symbolic of that never-ending union.
The most beautiful element of the temple is the ordinance that takes place that binds families together. And that gives us a great hope and something to look for and to live for.
The experience of the temple culminates in the celestial room that symbolizes heaven itself. This is where patrons can ponder, pray, and contemplate the joy of living eternally with Heavenly Father.
It is heavenly. There's a sacred, reverent feeling in the celestial room. In the other rooms, we'll receive instruction, we worship, we pray. When we go into the celestial room, it's a place where we can contemplate, reverently meditate, and silently pray. It's a very personal experience.
As daily life goes on, the Tokyo Japan Temple will once again be a sanctuary of peace and tranquility for generations to come.